गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस सेशन इज फॉर क्लास 11th एंड वी आर स्टडिंग कॉन्टिन्यूसली मोशन इन प्लेन एंड द टॉपिक इज प्रोजेक्टाइल मोशन. स्टूडेंट्स, इन लास्ट सेशन वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द टॉपिक प्रोजेक्टाइल मोशन एंड देन वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द टू वेलोसिटी कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ प्रोजेक्टाइल मोशन. ओके, then we have completed the topic that is horizontally launched projectile. You can see here, okay, and we solved this example which is shown on your screen. Students, today we are going to study the topic that is known as vertically launched projectile. Okay, so let's start vertically launched projectile. I hope you understand the meaning by the name that is vertically launched. It means in this case the projectile is not launched horizontally, but it is launched at some angle theta with the horizontal, or you can say with the surface of the earth. Okay, so this type of projectile is known as vertically launched projectile. So you can see in this picture, this picture shows the path of vertically launched projectile. Okay, so during the upward motion you can see here, in this is the point of the maximum height. Okay, so you can see this is the maximum height point, and you can see these are the different points, and you can see the vertical component and the horizontal component at each and every point. The most important point to take care in this case is you can see the length of this horizontal vector remains unchanged throughout the motion. This means we can say that the horizontal component in projectile motion is always constant and it is independent on the gravitational attraction of the earth. This is because the gravitational attraction is always perpendicular to the direction of the horizontal component of the particle, horizontal component of velocity of the particle, or you can say projectile. Okay, but if we are talking about the vertical component, you can see when the projectile is moving up, then these component, that is the vertical component of velocity, is continuously decreasing. And at the higher most point, or you can say the highest point of the path, its value becomes zero. This is the most important point to be remember, to understand and to solve the questions related to projectile motion. Okay, so must remember this point, that is the component of vertical component of velocity at highest point of the path of projectile is zero. After that, when in the second half motion, it means when projectile moving downward, the component, that is vertical component of velocity, is continuously increasing, because in this case it is in the direction of the gravitational attraction. Okay, so from this discussion we can summarize our statement like this, that is during upward motion the vertical component of velocity is continuously decreasing because it is opposite to the gravitational attraction, and during downward motion it is continuously increasing because it is in the direction of gravitational attraction. Okay, so students, I hope you understand why the horizontal component of velocity remains unchanged throughout the motion, whereas the vertical component is continuously decreasing. When the particle or projectile is moving upward and it is continuously increasing in the same rate when it is moving in downward. Okay, so now you can see here the horizontal component of velocity is constant and the vertical component increases on the way down. No vertical component at the top of the trajectory. This point is actually for here. Okay, so you can see there is no vertical component of velocity at top of the trajectory. Okay, so I hope you understand the concept of vertically launched projectile. So let me repeat the statements, and that are: when a projectile launched at an angle theta from the horizontal, the projectile is known as vertically launched projectile. Okay, after that, these projectile also have two components. First one is vertical component and second one is horizontal component. Okay, now the vertical component is continuously decreasing when projectile is moving upward and decreasing when it is moving downward, whereas the horizontal component throughout the motion remains unchanged. So this is about the vertically launched projectile. Now let us compare. So you can see here the component. So there are two components. First one is horizontal component and second one is vertical. Okay, let us talk about the magnitude. So the magnitude of horizontal component is constant, whereas for vertical component it is decreases up and the zero becomes at the highest, or you can say top of the path, and increasing, or you can say increases when it is moving downward. If you are talking about the direction, then direction of horizontal component is constant and it is always parallel to the surface of the earth, whereas the vertical component it changes, and when projectile is moving up it is opposite to the gravitational attraction, and when it moves downward it is in the same direction of the gravitational attraction. Okay, so this is about the component, magnitude and direction of vertically launched projectile. I hope you understand and you are getting my point. Okay, so students, try to note these things in your notebook. It will help you to understand the concept when you will try to study by yourself by using your textbook. Okay, so try to note these things. These are very important, and the most important point to remember is that at the highest point the magnitude of vertical component of velocity will be zero. This is very interesting point in case of vertically launched projectile. Okay, now let's see here. So we are going to resolve the velocity into two components. You can see the vertically launched projectiles. Since the projectile was launched at an angle, the velocity must be broken into components. So you can see the first component, that is Vox. This is x-axis, this is the horizontal component, whereas the vertical component is Voy. Okay, so you can see this one is the velocity vector actually. This one is the velocity vector. And this one is the vertical component. OK. okay, this one is vertical component, this one is horizontal component. So this vertical component is represented by VOY, whereas the horizontal component is represented by VOX. So this represent is equal to VO cos theta, you can see here, whereas this component is equal to VO sin theta. So you can see here, these two are the components. This one is horizontal component, VO cos theta. This one is vertical component, V naught sin theta, where theta is angle measured from the horizontal direction. So this point is very important. If angle is taken from the vertical, then this cos theta is replaced by sin theta, and the sin theta will be replaced by cos theta. So must remember, in this case of resolution of vector, that is velocity vector, the angle is measured from the horizontal axis, or you can say from the earth surface. Okay, so let's see here, vertically launched projectiles. So there are several things you must consider when doing these types of projectiles. Besides using components, if it begins and ends at ground level, the y displacement is zero. So this is very interesting point. If the level at which the projectile is launched and it will reach at the same level after its journey, so its vertical displacement is taken as zero. Okay, but there is not zero in horizontal displacement. You can see this one is presented by capital R. So vertical displacement in this case is taken as zero. Now you can see the velocity at this point is VO, and this one is resolved into two components. One of them is along the y axis, that is known as VOY, and the second one is along the x axis, that is VOX. Okay, now during all points of its path, you can see the magnitude of horizontal component remains unchanged throughout the motion, whereas the magnitude of the vertical components is continuously decreasing in when it is going up and decreasing when it is going down. So this is very interesting result, and at higher most point you can see VY is taken as zero. This is the point I am continuously talking about. This is, you must remember this point. This is very interesting and very important to apply the concept of projectile in different cases. Okay, so try to understand. Now you can see here at this point, when this projectile is fall down on the earth surface, it makes some angle theta with the horizontal. You can see here, so this angle is theta. Suppose this angle is theta, so you can calculate this angle theta by using the value of the component of velocity, that are Vx and Vy at this point. Now this Vy at this point is exactly equal to the Vy at this point in magnitude, but their directions are opposite. So to find the angle, you need the magnitude. So the magnitude of this one is equal to this one, but their directions are different. Okay, but you can see the direction of the horizontal component, that is VOX, it remains same, that is VOX, and the magnitude of this component is also same. So this one is the one most important characteristic of horizontal component. Okay, so I hope you understand about this picture which is shown in this figure on your screen. This displacement, that is the horizontal displacement between the launching point and the end point of the journey, is known as the range of the projectile. Okay, this one is known as range and denoted by capital R. And you can see the highest displacement at some point where the vertical component of velocity is zero is known as the height attained by the projectile. You can see the maximum height attained by the projectile. Okay, and now the time taken in this journey into the air is known as the time of flight. Okay, so this one is known as time of flight. The time taken in complete its journey into the air is known as time of flight. But in this case, we are not considering the resistance of air, or we are taking as it is negligible. Okay. So now we are going to find out the equation of motion, or you can say equation of vertically launched projectile. So for this purpose, let us see. You will start use the kinematics, but you must use component in this equation. So since this one is the vertical component, the value of this vertical component is V naught sine theta, where V naught is the initial velocity of the vector, or you can say the projectile. And here this one is the Vox, this one is the horizontal component of velocity. Okay, velocity of projectile. So since this component is unchanged, it means there is no acceleration, and we can directly use the formula. Displacement is equal to speed into time. Okay, so you will get the displacement traveled by the object along x direction in time t. But if we are talking about the vertical component, the velocity is not constant and the motion is accelerated motion. So in that case we must use equations of motion, and we want to find out the displacement traveled by the object along y axis in time t in the direction of the gravitational attraction. So we can write y is equal to v naught y, this means the vertical component, into t plus half gt square. Students, I hope you remember one thing, that the component voy in case of horizontally launched projectile is zero. So this y is, we took y is equal to half gt square in that case, but here this component, that is voy, is not zero. So we are taking y is equal to v naught y into t plus half gt square. Okay, so I hope you understand this concept of the horizontal and the vertical displacement. Okay, so you can see here this vox is equal to v naught cos theta, and VOY is equal to V naught sine theta. Now you can put these values in the above equations, that is X is equal to this V naught XT and Y is equal to this V naught YT plus half GT square. Okay. So let us understand the same thing with this example. You can see on your screen. Let me read first the question, that is: place cricketer kick a football with a velocity 20 meter per second and at an angle of 53 degree. Okay, so suppose this one is the football and it is kicked with velocity 20 meter per second at an angle 53 degree with the horizontal. Suppose this angle is 53 degree. Okay, then first one is how long is the ball in the air. So we have to find out the time period or time of flight, first one. B, how far away does it land. So this one is the distance along x direction. How high does it travel, this one is the maximum height of the projectile. Okay, so first let us find out the values of horizontal and vertical components. So this is the diagram when football is kicked with velocity 20 meter per second at an angle 53. You can see here the velocity components. This one is along x-axis and this one is along y-axis. Okay, this one is y-axis. So the horizontal axis, or you can say the horizontal component vox, is equal to v naught cos theta. And since v naught is 20, so you can write here 20, and cos theta is equal to 53, so this one is 53. After putting value of cos 53, you will get the value that is 12.04 meter per second. This one is the horizontal component of velocity, and it will be constant throughout the motion. Okay, here you can see VOI is equal to V naught sine theta. This one is the vertical component. Now VOI is equal to initial velocity into sine theta, that is sine 53. So VOI is equal to V naught sine 53, that is, after putting value of sine 53, you will get the value of the vertical component, 15.97 meter per second. These are the components of the velocity along x and y axis at the point of projection. Okay, but our aim is to find out the time period, or you can say time of flight. So let's see. So let's see, we are going to solve the first part, that is how long it the ball in the air. How long is the ball in air? So we need to find out the time t. Okay, so you can use the second equation of motion, that is y is equal to v naught y t plus half gt square. So as the vertical displacement after complete journey will be zero, so we can take this y as zero. Okay, now the component of velocity, that is vertical component, is 15.97. this is the value of g is 9.8. after dividing it by 2, you will get 4.9, and this negative sign shows that this the particle is moving in upward direction in first half case. So you can solve this 15.97 into t, and after solving this one is 15.97 is equal to 4.90. so you can divide this by 4.9 and you will get 3.26 seconds. Okay, so this one is the value of part A. So if you want to solve this question, if you prepare this type of table, it will help you to solve the questions. So let us see in this table what I know. So what are the values which already given and we know to solve this question? So first one is the horizontal component, that is we have already calculated, that is 12.04, so it means it is known. Then vertical component, that is 15.97 meter per second, it is also calculated by us, and so it is known. Y is equal to 0 because after complete journey the vertical displacement will be 0. Then the value of g is 9.8 meter per second square in the direction of the gravitational attraction, and minus 9.8 meter per second square opposite to the direction of gravitational attraction. Okay, now what I want to know, so for first question we want to know t, but we also don't know this x and this y. So in this question there are three parts. In first part we have to find out this t. In second part we have to find out the distance x, that is range, and in third part we have to find out the maximum height, that is y max. Thank you. Now you can see examples. So now the first one is completed and we have calculated the time t is equal to 3.26 seconds. Okay. Now we are going to solve the second part, that is x is equal to what. So let's see, how far away does it land? It means we want to find out the displacement along x-axis. So let's see, since x is equal to v naught xt, since this motion is not accelerated because velocity remains unchanged throughout the motion, so x is equal to v naught x into t. So it will be equal to the value of put value of v naught x into time 3.26, and after solution, or you can say after product, you will get the result in meter, because this velocity is given in meter per second and this time is taken in seconds. So this x is equal to 39.24 meter. So this one is the value of the horizontal displacement, or you can say the range of this projectile. Okay, so I hope you understand how you can solve this part, that is question number B. Now we are going to solve this third part, that is how high does it travel. So this one is the third part. So let's see what I know. These things are, we know, we have already discussed about this, and these two are also calculated by us, so these are also known. Now the final, we want to find out the y max, that is the maximum height attained by the projectile. For this purpose we can use second equation of motion, and suppose this y is the maximum height. Now at the highest, this component of velocity, that is 15.97, we have already known, the projectile must reach at this point in half of time of 3.26, because this 3.26 is the total time of journey. Total time of journey means it is total time to restart from its motion and reach to the ground. It means it must reach at the maximum height in half time. Okay, in half time here. So it is half time, right? So this one is the maximum height attained by this projectile. So the projectile took half of the 3.26 seconds to reach at this point. It means we take here, we are taking here t is equal to 1.63. Okay, so y is equal to 15.97 into 1.63 minus 1 by 2, g, value of g is 9.8. So after dividing it by 2, you will get 4.9, and then t square. So after calculation, these things, y is given as 13.01 meter. So now you can see from these discussions, in this case of projectile, the projectile took total time 3.26 seconds to complete its journey. Then it travels a distance along x-axis 39.24 meter in time 3.26 seconds, and it attains the maximum height, that is 13.01 meter, along y-axis. Okay. So students, I hope you understand the concept of this question and the concept of vertically launched projectile. Try to solve more questions given your textbook. It will help you to understand the concept in more deep way, and it will also help you to apply your knowledge in different cases and different application based and higher order thinking skill questions. Okay, so exercise is very important to understand anything and to remember the things. So try to exercise the questions every day, okay, and try to revise the topics which we have already discussed in previous classes, like horizontally launched projectile, which we have discussed yesterday, okay. So try to solve these things, and for any confusion you can contact, you can ask your questions, you can write in comments. So thank you for watching.